A very good morning to all the teachers present here. Thank you so much for being a part of Faculty Development Program version 2. And firstly, I would like to thank each and every teacher for making students' digital marketing workshop a great, great success. We had a participation of 30,000 students attending the session live on YouTube. And this is the power to all the teachers. This is the power of all the teachers that it was possible because of your effort, your word of mouth, that such a grand show could have been pulled out. We did not spend a single rupee on marketing the event. It was pure your effort. So congratulations for taking country's education to next level. And thank you so much for helping us out. Like a PM addressed yesterday, that every Indian has to put the effort of helping local go global. I think we teachers have doubled the responsibility, one as citizens and two as teachers, to make sure that we take Indian education to the global level. Now, how can we do that? Can we do that? Yes, definitely. And today's session is all about how what all we can do in online education to reach those global standards. Thank you so much again for being a part. I leave it over to Hitesh now to take over. I hope all your pens and papers and notepads are ready to take down the notes. We promise you an amazing, amazing session ahead. Thank you.
So how are you guys doing? Are you guys doing very, very well? Give me a quick yes on chat box in case you can see me. Or in case you can hear me first of all, and then now you can see me as well. All right. I can see a lot of yeses coming in. Pretty awesome. Okay. So now, first of all, I'd like to say thank you. Thank you so much for being here and spending your time with us on this morning. Without further ado, let's begin today's presentation. Let's exactly see that how can we start doing digital marketing from scratch for you guys, all right? So first of all, how many guys over here are excited? You're completely excited to take your journey of education online. If you're excited, type the word excited in the chat box. You're super excited to be over here. You're super excited to take your journey online. And I will keep on asking you to keep on chatting with me, because the more you guys chat, the more better it will be. And people currently on YouTube, my request is to take a notepad and a pen. And you guys should basically be making a notes. So in case you do not have people on Zoom, people on YouTube, in case you do not have notepad and a pen, please take a notepad and a pen. And you guys should actually be taking notes over here. What I'm going to share with you is going to be super exciting and super useful for yourself. All right. So first of all, welcome to all of you in this Faculty Development Program Pan India, where we're going to show you today how can you plan and design your online course. Currently, how many guys over here are struggling to even plan or design your online courses? Give me a quick eye on the chat box. All right. In case you're currently figuring out, you're still dilly-dally about how things really work, what is to be done, what's not to be done, give me a quick eye on chat box. I can see a lot of people, but don't worry. Today, I'm going to take your entire efforts go away, and I'm going to show you exactly how this is to be done. So now, some important points on before I start this meeting. This webinar is going to be purely in English. So my sincere apologies to people who are from tier 2 and tier 3 towns, because we got some friends from Chennai and southern part of the India, and unfortunately they do not have access, they can't understand Hindi. The webinar is going to be purely in English. This webinar is for everyone who is a part of a teaching system, maybe from a college or a principal, it's for everybody. Also, you'll get a certificate at the end of the session. This time the session is going to be for 2 days, it's not for 3 days. It's going to be about 2 days. And in case you're coming for the first time, I would like to welcome you. In case you're a part of my old FDP, I welcome you again as well. By the way, how many of your people over here have come here for the first time? Type the word first on the chat box. In case you come here for the first time. All right, I can see Madhvi, Kalpana, Aarti, Nidhi, Naveen, Mayur, a lot of people come for the first time. Okay, fantastic. And this webinar is more practical oriented. So you're going to have a lot of tools. You're going to have a lot of learnings, and most importantly, you will be able to take some concrete steps at your home, and you can start implementing straight out of the webinar. And that's what really our USP is, because we believe only in practical education and not just theoretical education, right? Now, will you get certificates? Yes, you will get a certificate after the end of every day, after the end of every session of mine. There'll be a testing which will be given to you. That is going to be your attendance. So I really want you to be here till about 11 o'clock to 12:30. And sometimes we might extend till 1, but we'll try to wrap up by 12:30. All right. And you will only get certificates for people who give the test. Let me make it very clear one more time. You'll only get certificates only when we basically give the test. So ensure that you give the test. Right, at the end, the test is going to be very simple. It's a multiple choice question. It's not anything very hard. If you've been a part of it before, you'll be able to understand things very well. Let me tell you what we have. So today, day number one, we're going to show you exactly that. How do you plan your online journey? How do you plan your course? How do you design it? How do you ensure that there's a maximum engagement among your students? That's your first level. Tomorrow, I'm going to show you some best practices for online teaching. How can you make your online teaching a bit more fun? And what can you do essentially to make your online teaching a bit more palatable for students? Because the way online teaching is new for you, online learning is new for students as well. So they both of you are currently adjusting to the new normal, right? So we're going to try to make you more comfortable between today and tomorrow. So don't worry, tomorrow again, same time, 11 o'clock, you should be here. All right. First of all, we currently need to understand that students are one of the stakeholders of ours who want to learn in the new normal. And the second stakeholder is teachers who want to teach in the new normal. So see, online education, unfortunately, is not an option anymore. You have to adopt it. We do not know how long this pandemic will last, but we have to adopt to online learning and online teaching because that's the way forward. And that's how country can also go ahead. Because countries can only go ahead if they're able to, mass educate people. And this is, if you really ask me, it's a blessing in disguise for most of us because let's take in classrooms, we're limited to 10, 20, 30, 40, 100, 200 people. Online, there's no limit. Like, look at this particular webinar itself. I am currently addressing almost 4,000 plus teachers coming from different parts of India right now, just because of the power of online, which you can have not done before in the online world. But yes, it's about being comfortable out there. And today what we'll see is we'll see how do we effectively design and deliver an online course. And most importantly, how can you become an expert in that? How many guys over here want to become an expert in delivering online sessions? Type the word me on the chat box. So what I would recommend is, in case you're here for the first time, you should go to our YouTube channel and you should basically look at our past videos. In that, we share a lot of tips, a lot of tricks on how can you basically start assessing people, how can you start delivering better lectures, and also some tips on, telling you how to use Zoom effectively. But in this session, okay, we're going to see basically how do you plan your curriculum? How do you plan and design effectiveness in the online learning, all right? And in case you're on YouTube, my sincere request is to press the icon of subscribe, and people on Zoom, you can also go to YouTube and press subscribe button so that you always get notified when we are coming up with new sessions for all of you, all right? So if you see today, the world is changing with time, but the question is, are you? Now, who is the biggest competition to online education? Sometimes we feel that our competitors are other education institutes. That's not the case, my friends. Your education institutes, who is the biggest problem? The biggest competition for you today is brands like Netflix, WhatsApp, YouTube, PUBG, and Amazon Prime. How many of you guys over here currently agree that today when you're teaching, there are kids busy playing games. There are kids busy playing, busy watching videos. And that's our biggest competition, my friends. And that's what we need to attack. We need to make our learning so exciting that people today come to you rather than watching Netflix and watching YouTube. Because remember, Netflix and YouTube cannot shape their careers, but we as teachers can shape their careers. And that's the power of teachers, my friend. Because without the teaching ecosystem, the country will go to a standstill. So trainers, teachers are one of the biggest backbones of the entire country. There's a huge responsibility in our head to actually go out there and do something for the nation, right? And most importantly, if you're teaching online and it cannot be boring at all. So I understand that some of you might be facing this absolutely newly for the first time and you're wondering, okay, how can I make it more effective? How can I make it more better? I'm trying my best, but then this is not, I'm not able to do things. There are always ways, there are always hacks to do this. And today I'm going to show you exactly how do we do that, right? So your teaching cannot be boring because if it's boring, kids will sleep off and they wouldn't like and they wouldn't want to come back to you. Right? They'll just come here for one thing, which is called attendance and nothing else, right? So let's now understand that, how do we take it forward? So if you really ask me, you don't have an option today whether you want to go online or not. It's all about how you embrace online, how you go online. That's the only thing which is available for us. And your teaching aid has to be like Netflix. So, you know, though you're competing with Netflix, but you should become a Netflix for students, where the students keep coming back to you again and again and again and again, because that's what they deserve, right? Now, let's understand what are the different problems in online teaching. The first biggest problem in online teaching is there's a lack of student interaction. That means you're teaching, but unlike offline, people can smile, people can give you visual cues. You don't see that. You're just speaking to a camera. But remember, guys, this camera, don't think it's a camera. This camera is a world. Because when you speak to this camera, you're speaking to the entire world. Second thing, there is a way in which we can get people to interact with you. If you agree with me that this currently is one of the biggest problems, type the word I on the chat box. In case you agree with me, that is one of the biggest problems. Correct? You see, when I start my webinar, I'm constantly engaging with you. Right? That's what you should do. You should always keep on telling them to type something or the other. Because when they keep on typing, they keep on registering in their brain that they have to pay attention, right? So I used to always say that fingerprints are brain prints, but today typing is brain prints because people don't no longer write. People actually keep on typing, right? And that's what really it is, okay? Number two, there are a huge amount of distractions at home for students. So let's take some mother is saying some work. He is currently doing something at his place and plus listening to a lecture. There's a huge amount of distractions. So by constantly engaging with him, by constantly talking to him, you can basically avoid distractions, right? That's again one of the small tips that I have for you. Now, next one from a teacher perspective, what are the problems? Now, being at home, even teachers are facing the same problem where they have to balance between the household chores and basically their work. How many of you guys are facing tough time right now balancing both of them, balancing your household chores as well as balancing online tasks? Type the word me on the chat box in case you're facing a big time right now. It happens. So which is why what you need to do is you need to keep a separate space at your home, which can be your work zone, right? Now, I know like in Bombay, the house is very small. So like, you know, so what I normally do is I quarantine one of my room space and I actually keep that as my work zone. So I know, okay, this is my dedicated zone that I'll work and nobody should basically be disturbing me over here. And plan your time accordingly. So plan it early so that you can start finishing the lectures early. Right. And most importantly, the last and the biggest challenge, you know, for teachers is sometimes we are not comfortable with online tools. And which is why, you know, we at Nordstrom Academy have decided to bridge this gap. We're going to make you comfortable with online tools currently. How many of you guys over here feel that this is exactly your story? This is exactly what you're facing right now. Type the word agree on the chat box. Simply agree. This is the major problems that we are facing right now while doing online teaching. Right. And we're going to show you exactly how to overcome these challenges in short time from now. Let's go forward. Now, how can you overcome this gap? So you can overcome this gap only with one thing, my friends, that's effective planning. You need to plan your curriculum so well, that in a very methodical fashion, you'll be able to complete your portion on time. Students will be able to get value on time. And most importantly, both the parties are very, very happy in this. So they need to overcome the hurdle. Now, apart from effective planning, what do we need? So there are three hurdles that you need to cross in case you want to actually do this. The first hurdle that you want to cross is planning. Planning is the first step in whatever we do. So we need to first plan our curriculum. I'm going to give you a template today that will actually help you to plan your curriculum effectively. This template in the market, if I'm not kidding, like when we made this template for a lot of institutions, so we also made a lot of courses for, you know, for a lot of institutions in the market. Maybe we've made a course for, you know, very top A-grade institutions. And for this kind of planning effort that we do for them, we should charge them a bomb, like almost, you know, close to nothing less than 4 to 5 lakh of contract for just making their design curriculum ready. But today, I'm going to give it to you for absolutely free. How many of you guys over here want to lay your hands on this template for you to make effective plan and effective curriculum? Type the word I want on the chat box in case you want to do that. And I'm going to show you exactly how to start and how do we do it step by step. Okay. The second thing which you want to do is basically you need to have teaching aids. So what are teaching aids? Teaching aids are not that. See, you cannot be teaching every single aspect online because online some things become very difficult. For example, science experiments become difficult. Right. Sometimes maths can still be taught online, but you know something which requires a laboratory or something that requires a setup, something that requires, for example, botany, plants, it becomes difficult. So in that you need teaching aids. So what are teaching aids? Can you essentially pick up some open source content from your YouTube and you can start sharing that as a part of a curriculum? Yes or no? What do you feel? If you're not thought of this yet, you should be thinking of this. So YouTube, Udemy, and Coursera have started giving free courses to people. So whatever basically you're not currently doing it, right, you should be taking it from there and tell the students to complete a free module. Without that, the grades won't be counted. And at the end of the day, the best part about these things is they give you a certificate as well. You can tell them to complete the course, get the certificate printed, and show that to the college so that you can plan your curriculums accordingly, right? And most importantly, the third hurdle, which is there, you need to make an online course so easy for them that it will develop a spark of motivation on them, that they feel a part of the community and they feel, you know what, this is exactly what I wanted. This is exactly what I want to do. Correct? That's what you should be doing. So you need to do three things, my friends. You need to, first of all, effectively plan. You need to have some teaching aids. So teaching aids, you can use Coursera, Udemy, and YouTube. And third thing is, make the online course a bit motivational so that that'll basically drive a spark in them to come over there. So the idea is you need to make ETM, effective planning, teaching aids, in making an online course design. Three things, ETM. Type on the chat box ETM so that you note this down, it registers in your brain, and you are going to do these three things today with me practically live. All right, let's go forward. Now, let's understand that what motivates students. Let's understand from their perspective. Right? So if we see what motivates students is grades. Everybody, ultimately, how much ever we do something, they all want good grades. Right? Second thing, apart from grades, they also want good gratitude. That means they need to voice out somewhere. They need to be heard. And somebody needs to thank them also. So you should also have a bit of gratitude towards them. Right? Number three, okay, is basically you need to also have recognition, because recognition also motivates you. For example, if you remember in the school days, when we were small, there's a small thing that teachers should do. She used to always give a star sticker. How many of you guys remember this? In your school, you used to get the star sticker, okay, from your teacher for doing any good job. And how much of a stars you get, the more happy the kid used to be. I'm sure that some of you teachers in the pre-primary school already do this right now. But this is what I remember when I was in school, and I still remember this. Even after so many years, I still remember that. Why? As a human being, we all love to be recognized. Okay, and we all love to be a part of it. So you need to get the recognition culture online as well. And this is all possible online. You can do all these things online today. I'm going to exactly show you how. Right? And the last things over here is that you need to make them competitive. Okay, because competition, okay, can actually help them, okay, to nurture further, to do things at a better pace. And I'm not saying, have bad competition, have healthy competition among them. And I'm going to show you some very good tools today that will actually help you to gamify your curriculum. How many of you guys over here want to learn how to gamify your curriculum? Type the word G on the chat box. In case you want to know how to gamify. That's what the answer to the entire thing is. If you gamify, and if you are able to give them grades, you're able to give them recognition, you're able to give them competition, right? A gratitude will come to them automatically. They will be thankful for such a different learning experience to all of you. And ultimately, you are the torchbearers of India for tomorrow. And when you start doing things, that's when things can actually happen. All right? Let us understand that, how do we bridge this gap? So you can bridge this gap by only doing one thing, by making a course that sparks students to work. The idea is you need to keep them busy and you need to channelize their energies. The more the energies are channelized, the better for you, and the more easier tasks you have at your hand. Now, there are different types of course design. Let me now take a moment to explain to you what are different types of courses for us currently, and how should you be building a course design for yourself right now. Okay, so the first type of course is what we call is synchronized learning. We also normally call this real-time learning. So what I'm doing right now is I'm doing a synchronized learning. It's a real-time learning. When I'm coming live, I'm addressing your questions, I'm talking to you live, and I'm able to speak to you and understand your queries and concerns, right? So currently, the most effective way for all the teachers is to always do synchronous learning, do real-time learning, because the impact that real-time has, that same impact a recorded session might not have. But having said that, some of you might be comfortable doing an offline, or some of you might be comfortable doing a recording session as well. So we normally call this the asynchronous learning. That means it's a self-paced program. Students can actually look at the video whenever they want, wherever they want, and they can actually start doing that. But there can be a combination of both. For example, people who can attend live will attend live. People who cannot attend live, I will start giving them recordings. Can you do that? Do you think that's a better idea? We normally call this a hybrid approach, right? So you should be doing in a hybrid approach where you should be doing both the things together. You should be doing synchronous learning by doing live lectures. You should be doing asynchronous learning by having a self-paced program. In case you want to understand that how do we use Zoom or how do we use real-time tools effectively, okay, watch my video in the past of FDP lecture day 2. Go to Nostrum Academy YouTube channel, watch my video, because in that video I've explained to you how can you be better at online learning, right? How can you do real-time learning? So do that, watch that video. Number two, okay, if you want to do self-paced learning, watch my day number 1, which I did last time, where I told you how to make a LMS, a free learning management system for yourself. So you can actually do that. You can actually make a free course and you can start distributing to your students and prospects and other people. That is how you will be branding yourself. Remember, my friends, the best teacher never wins. The best known teacher always wins. So you need to become the best known teacher. You need not become the best teacher. How many of you guys over here want to become the best known? Type the word BK on the chat box. Because I want all my teachers, all my people to become the best known. And that's my aim, my friends. You know, I want to train over 1 lakh teachers in this next 1 year. And it's all possible because of your support and your energy. Without you guys, you know, we would not be able to get so many people over here. All right. Now the third program, the third type of online learning is called cohort program. What is cohort? Cohort basically is what we call is sequential programs, where you don't jump chapters. You will go first you complete the 1 chapter. After that, only you will have the 2nd chapter. After that, only you will have the 3rd chapter. So it goes in a sequential format. Sometimes what happens is we might take the easy chapter first and tough chapters in the middle, or might omit some chapters. But in cohort programs, you always go in a sequential fashion. You would not jump anything or any modules here and there. So that's a third type of online course which you can design, which is the cohort programs. Then the next type of program over here is what we call as flipped classrooms. You know what are flipped classrooms? Where you don't teach them anything. This only happens in US and UK. A lot of international universities do this. Okay. Some of the IIMs also do this, where the faculty does not teach at all. The faculty gives them a recorded video. They give them books. They ask them to learn. And then they have a fixed time for question answers every week. And then they only solve doubts. If the student does not learn at that stipulated time, that's his mistake. That's not the mistake of the institute. That's what we call as flipped classrooms. So it is basically only question answers plus self-led learning together. How many of you guys over here think that flipped classroom might work in India or might not work in India? If you think it will work, type the word yes. If you think it won't work, type the word no in the chat box, right? So flipped classroom is a very bold move, if you really ask me, okay? It is not that easy to do this, because then in that case, you need to be more commanding over the students to get things done from them. And today we all know, you know, that how students are, okay? So you can actually do that as well. Now, the next one, okay, is what I call is internship or assignment based. This is one of the best ways to impart learning. Okay. Where what you simply do over here is you start giving them projects. You start giving them live projects. There are companies who are ready to fund or even for free, does not matter. But this kind of learning will change the entire education system in India. Okay. Why? It's because when they start doing things practically, when they go for a job, they will be able to effectively do things on their own. They become self-dependent. So what you can do over here is you can start giving them a project. So you can say, this is the, so for example, I'll tell you my example in marketing. So I'll give them a strategy saying that, you know what, there is this brand, currently they want to launch in India. They do not know how to launch in India. Now, your task is to actually make them launch in the country. And how do you do that? That's completely your choice. All right. So what we simply do is we simply give them an assignment or a task. And all these people need to actually do their task on their own.
Hitesh, just one request. Can you ask everyone on YouTube to just refresh once? They are saying their chat is disabled. Just ask them to refresh once and it will be fine. If they have a mobile app, just ask them to close the mobile app and open again.
Sure. So my request to everyone on YouTube currently is, if you are watching me on YouTube right now, refresh the screen. Just press enter or just use the refresh button in your top and you should be able to see the chat buttons. And if you are currently on mobile app, just log out and log in again. You should be able to do that again. So just log out, click on the same link again and come back. You should be able to listen to us live. You should be able to listen to us on chat. In case chat feature is enabled for you, type the word yes on the chat box only on YouTube. All right, enough people over here. Okay, now, So then we basically have what we call as internship and assignment based solutions. So this is one of the most effective solutions for you. All right. And most importantly, the last one is what we call as peer learning, or we normally call this mentor based learning. All right. Where essentially what you simply do is you simply get students to teach each other. So you tell the student that this 20-year student will have chapter number one, this will have chapter number two, this will have chapter number three. So every week, one student will come live and they will actually teach to the class. And then students can ask them questions. And whatever the students are not able to answer, then the mentor who will basically be answering them. We normally call this peer-based learning. So these are essentially six types of course designs which you can create. So you can create a course design in real time, which we're doing right now. You can have self-paced program, which is recorded programs. You can have cohort, which is sequential programs. Okay. Third is, what is flipped classes? Flipped classes basically is where you only do question answers, let students learn the chapter and come on their own. Next is you do internship and assignment based questions. And next is peer learning. Okay. Peer learning basically is where you get students to talk to each other. Right. So people on Zoom, everybody chats is visible. Don't worry about it. On Zoom, there's no problem. Only for people on YouTube, there's a problem. So Zoom, I can see your chat, Madhura, Dr. Parul, Damyanti, I can see all your chats. Synchronous learning is what we're doing right now, what we're seeing currently in real time. So if you see, I'm just talking to you and you're currently chatting with me, right? This is synchronous learning currently. So are we clear with this? And did you find this extremely, extremely useful? Give me a quick yes on the chat box. And did you find this extremely, extremely useful? Yep. Are you finding this webinar full of value? If you are, type the word V on the chat box. You're finding it completely valuable because this is how you design curriculum. And what I'm telling you is, I'm not telling you from an Indian perspective, I'm talking from a global perspective. If you have to design a curriculum from a global standards, how can you design a curriculum from global standards, right? That's what you should be doing. Let's go next right now. So the simple answer to this is, now how do you make a curriculum? How do you make a design? So this is my template. And I normally call this the golden quadrant. So if you implement the golden quadrant, your course design, your course curriculum will be one of the best in the industry. And I guarantee you, once you see this method, it's so easy, it's so effective that you can not only design curriculum for your own. My request is to go out there and help all the other faculties who are currently there in your college and tell them how to make the golden quadrant. So golden quadrant is very simple. You take a piece of paper and divide them into four parts. So take a piece of paper, divide them into four parts. Okay. You can do it timely. You can do 1, 2, 3, 4. Just divide them into four parts. Now, the first part, you write what we call a syllabus. So I'm sure that if you're a college faculty, pre-primary faculty, or school faculty, whichever grade that you're teaching currently in, you will all have a certain syllabus with you, unless you're an independent trainer, then you have to make your own syllabus, right? So first things first, you need to make a syllabus. All right. So write down chapter number one, chapter number two, chapter number three, chapter number four, basically whatever you're teaching. Second step is to basically outline that each syllabus, what will be the key learning? What are they going to learn after each and every chapter? And what is that one or two thing that they'll achieve? So even if you're in a pharma space or in the kid space, let's take you in the early childhood education, you can still do this. You can say, if they learn this, they'll be understanding basics of surgery. If they do this, they'll be understanding how to dissect a human body. If they do this, they'll be understanding that where can the problem be found, right? If you're in school, same logic, right? You can say by doing this, their motor ability will go up, their thinking ability will go up, cognitive ability will go up, whatever it is. And for a college, it's very simple. It is more practical oriented. You will say if they learn digital marketing, they will be able to actually make a digital marketing plan. They'll be able to answer social media. They'll be able to make content. They'll be able to actually start conducting sessions live, whatever it is. That's your key learning. So what is the outcome of your course? But normally what we do is we normally get the outcome for the entire course. Don't do that. What is the outcome of every chapter, every syllabus of yours? What is the outcome for that? Then number three, you have to give a timeline to it. Now, one small tip on the online learning space, people who are doing it for the first time, remember that 2 hours class in offline is only 1 hour class in online. That means online, the time of the delivery reduces. Why? Unlike offline classes, you do not talk to people out there, right? That means, yes, you're talking to people via chats, but essentially, you do not essentially speak to people, in a way that they did in the offline class, right? So you have to give a timeline to each class and give a timeline which is very short. And when you start teaching people live, remember that your classroom is for 1 hour. You should only teach for 20 to 30 minutes. And the next 30 minutes have to be activity-based learning. So you should follow what I call the 30-30 rule. 30 minutes, half and half is basically half is learning and half is practical oriented. So I want all of you type in the chat box 30-30, okay? Because that is what really it is. You need to essentially have 30-30. Okay, because I want you to do things methodically, because the more methodical approach you keep, the better it is for you and the better you'll be able to learn faster, right? And the last step, okay, which is a big gap, which is basically bridging the gap between the traditional curriculum and the new curriculum for the online, is you need to also plan in-class activity and assessments in your sheet. These are the four things you will plan for your curriculum. One is a syllabus. That means what are you going to teach? What is the outcome of what you're going to teach? What is the timeline? How much time will you complete things on? And then in-class activity. So this is what we call as SKTI. Or you can also call this SKIT. Okay, SKIT. Syllabus, key learnings, in-class activity, and assessments and timelines. So type in the chat box SKIT. So you need to apply what I call the SKIT learning model, SKIT. And this particular learning model is designed by us. Okay, we have designed this particular model for a lot of institutes in India and abroad. And this is what we do. We actually help the education go simplified. Okay, and this is what you all should be doing. You should be all applying the SKIT model. So what you should be simply doing over here currently is, just make this table in front of you. If you want to take a photograph of this table, it will be helpful for you. And you can share this with the academic committee, with your core teams, with your principals. And you should all follow this template. Make a simple Excel sheet, divide the Excel sheet into four parts, right? First, write down the syllabus. I'll give my own example. If I'm doing a digital marketing syllabus, I'll write fundamental digital marketing, I teach basics. And I'll teach you how to brand yourself, how to write content, how do we basically do social media marketing, how do we run ads. That's my syllabus. That's what I'm teaching step by step by step by step. Then what's the learning for you? I've got learnings mapped to each of my syllabus. After that, what I'll be doing is I have to also plan in-class activity. So let's take whenever I basically start doing, let's take for example, my overview on questions. I'll start with all of you right now. Right? I want all of you to type C on the chat box in case you want me to show you how it is done. Okay. Now, people on YouTube, there might be a bit of 30 seconds lag for you guys. So just bear with me. Okay. So the first tool I'm going to show you, the first learning aid inside the classroom is you should always have quizzes with your curriculum, because quiz can make your curriculums more attractive. It can make your curriculum more better. Now, what is the best app for doing quiz? I use an application called Kahoot. K-A-H-O-O-T. Kahoot. Kahoot is one of the beautiful apps. It can actually help you to plan your curriculums better. It also helps you to do things better. Now, the best part about Kahoot is, Kahoot currently is giving its premium version for absolutely free if you're from college. So when you sign up on Kahoot, signing up is very easy. Just click on sign up and you can just put your name, email ID, phone number. Sign up on Kahoot, you have to tell them that you're from a college or a school or an education background. Because if you do not do that, if you do not tell them from education background, they would not allow you to make this quiz. Remember people, you need to tell them you're from education background. Okay, now let's play Kahoot live. First, I'm going to show you how do you play. Then I'm going to show you how to make your quiz online for people to interact with you. Okay, and the best part is this quiz is gradable. I can get this course. I can also see who's most engaged. All right, and I'm going to show you how to do engagement live. So how many guys over here are ready to play with me? Type the word ready on the chat box and you're ready to play with me. You're ready to play, you know, you're ready to gamify your online experience and online learning for everybody right now. Type the word, I am ready on the chat box. Okay, fantastic. So now I want all of you guys to currently, okay, go to... I want all of you guys to currently go to Kahoot.it. So in case you're from desktop, you have to use a separate device. You can't be using, suppose you're using for mobile phone, and only one mobile phone, unfortunately, you can't play this game then. You need to be using separate devices. Okay. So you need to be using two devices. One for playing the game, okay, and one for watching the webinar. Because the questions are going to come over here, the answers will be giving it on your phone. So I want all of you guys to go to kahoot.it. It will ask you for a game pin, and I wanted to put this game pin. So when you put the game pin, it will ask you for a game pin and nickname. When you put your game pin, we can basically see your name coming over here. So we can see a lot of names coming over here. Sahil, Sudha, SKM, Tarak, TVS, Helen, Gayatri. Okay. The game pin for people is 166315. So go to kahoot.it, put the game pin, 166315. So people are not getting it. You need to go to kahoot.it. Take a separate device, take a separate number, type kahoot.it. Nickname is your name, your personal name. So when you put your name will come on the screen. As you can see currently, there are about 345 people currently playing this live with us. And the number should be going up. Right? So somebody, if your name is taken by somebody else, type something else, type Dr. Parul or something. I can't even see the names. It's going so fast currently. So let me explain you how does this game actually work. This game is very simple. It's okay. So if you don't have device, just see what I'm doing right now. You can do the same thing later on with your classroom. So people who don't have devices, don't worry at all. You can play this game afterwards as well. Practice today. Okay. Now let me explain you how does it really work. So this game is very simple. There will be approximately 4 questions coming on your screen, one by one. You have to answer every question one by one. Okay. Over here. So there'll be a question coming on my screen. You'll get 20 seconds to answer each question. When the timer starts, you need to simply select, okay, the right answer. The more faster you are and the more correct answers you give, the more points you get. So it's only for people who are fast and who give correct answers. That's what it is. The pin is here on the screen right now is 166315. Let's start the game because, we've got a lot more things to cover. So there are about 1400 people currently playing it live. So this is the first question coming on the screen right now. 3, 2, 1. The first question is, what describes you the best? This is a very open-ended question. Just type the answer in chat box. So this, I just want to interact with my students, but I want people to just write what describes them the best. So you're awesome, you're good, you're a teacher, you're a change maker. What are you? Just type one word. So what you can do is when you start a session, this can be an icebreaker for you, where you just break an ice with them. People just type their answers. And then we can see a good word cloud and we can see what do everybody thinks in the class. What do they feel? 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And this basically ends over here. All right. We've got 730 people answering this question. Let's see, okay, what the words are. So what describes you all the best is awesome, teacher, good, creative, change maker, cool, honest, simple, friendly, best, patient, confident, passionate. So when you do this, everybody feels a part of the family. Everybody feels, I'm so connected. Everybody is an awesome teacher. Everybody is good teacher. Everybody is smart. Everybody is creative. So that brings energy in the room. It really helps you to channelize the crowd all together, right? This is the first type of quiz. Normally, we call this the quiz to be word cloud quizzes. There's no right or wrong answer. People will just type one word. And whatever words they type, it keeps on coming on your screens over here right now. Did you guys love this one? Type the word, love it in the chat. We really love this one. Okay. Okay, now let's go next. Let's basically go to the next question. So next question over here is, okay, I guess a word cloud. When I say digital marketing, what's the first thing comes to your mind? So then you can introduce subject to them. You can tell them that, hey, if I say science, what's the first thing comes to your mind? If I say toddler, what's the first thing comes to your mind? If I say something like, surgery, what is the first thing comes to your mind? So depending on which field you are in, you can just put your one word about a subject. So rather than them speaking, because see, if everybody speaks in the class, it won't really help. So 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So people are typing their answers right now. We've got about 500 responses in this one, correct? So this is how you can introduce a subject. So when you start a subject, you can just play this word cloud game. And then you can figure out that what do people say about a subject? Do they like it? They don't like it? What is the one thing? So people say awesome, internet, Amazon, technology, Zoom, advertising, Facebook, money, computer, business. This is the first impression. Then you can say, you know what? Yes, digital marketing is internet. It's about having awesome learnings. It's about making money on it. It's about making Facebook. It's about social media. It's about ads. So this becomes like a very interactive medium for people, and people start connecting with you on the spot. So first, keep an open-ended question. Second, keep a question about your subject. All right. Then let's go to the next question. Are you ready for the next question, people? Yep. If you're ready, we go next. Next question. The third question, this is a polling question. How would you rate the session right now? Are you enjoying the session? Are you not enjoying the session? So right, excellent, cool, okay, or the best. So just tick mark the right answer, whatever you feel. So again, it's not a wrong or right answer. It's just to engage people. It's a live poll which you can conduct. So for example, you can give them four options. You can say, which one do you think is the most likely option for you? Okay, as you can see, people are saying excellent, cool, okay, and the best, okay? All right, fantastic. Now, the next question is, where to give the right answer? So what is the first step to overcome the hurdle of online teaching? If you remember, I just told you last time, give some more assignment, effective planning, give them more homework, or let students teach us, which is the most effective way to overcome the hurdle of online teaching. Tick mark the right answer. For 20 more seconds. And also you can time your quizzes, by the way. So you can just time the quiz, you can keep it so that you can get the responses faster from people. Let's see how many of you guys got this answer right. So 3, 2, 1, and that's it. Okay. So the right answer for this one is effective planning. So planning was the first step which we discussed in the online teaching. It's not to get more student assignments or give them, you know, more homework, less students teach us. It is the effective planning. Let's see which people got this right. So then we can get top five people who got this right. Currently we can see Kia, Pradnya, Ipsita, Saji, and Gauri Dash. They all got this question answer right. All right. Okay, let's go next. The fifth question. What is the first quadrant? Which of this is the first quadrant of the golden quadrant, which I told you? It's timeline, it's syllabus, it's in-class activity, or key learning. So then whatever you're teaching in the class, you can actually play a quiz like this and get people to interact with them. And they see, when they see the names coming up on board, they feel really excited and they feel that, you know, they're a part of your learning, they're a part of your teaching, and they want to actually do this thing for themselves. This is the largest ever Kahoot played online, by the way. So now all of you got the drill. Let's see how many responses come in. 20 seconds more to go. Five, 4, 3, 2, 1. We got almost 1600 plus responses coming over here. Congratulations to all of you. And if you're exactly right, this is the first quadrant is what we call as a syllabus. You first write the syllabus, key learning, then the timelines, and the in-class activity. You can also interchange in-class activity and timeline together as well. That's no problem at all. And then once the quiz is over, we can get the winners over here. So then the winners come with the person who answered the highest. So the first winner is called Nazima. Congratulations, Nazima. Second is Guru. And second and first. This is the first winner. Is Vicky V. So in case you're in this classroom over here, I congratulate you to come live. And Nancy and Jaji are fourth and the fifth people right now. Right? This is how you can gamify things online. And it really works wonders. Everybody just glued on, and all the students just love playing a game like this. How many teachers over here actually loved playing a game like this? You enjoyed this particular segment over here the most. I want to see, you know, how many of you loved it. Type the word love it in the chat box if you love this particular thing. That's what you should do, people. You should make curriculum more fun. When you make teaching fun, everybody will actually do this, right? And that's what the game is, my friends. That's how it really works. Now, how many of you guys want to learn how to make a quiz? You want to actually see the back end of this? Yeah? Okay. Let me show the back end to you. How does it really work? So it's very simple. Yes, absolutely free. The best part is Kahoot is absolutely free. It's not, they're not charging you a single rupee right now. You can actually do this for yourself. So this is, I just give you a small demo of a quiz right now. This is how you do quizzes. So you start having interaction with people. You start having debate with people out here, right? So the same thing when I did Rosie, you know, the way I'm doing right now, sharing my screen over here, telling you guys to do it, you can do that way. Absolutely same way for them. Okay, so let me now show you how do we do it practically, all right? So first things first, you have to make an account. When you make an account, you just request Kahoot to give you a premium version for free. Like I've got a premium version for free right now, but I already had a premium version beforehand also. I had paid money for that as well. But currently for all the teachers who are currently teaching somewhere, okay, you can actually do it for absolutely free. So the premium version currently is for free for everybody. Neha, everybody is getting this version for free right now because of COVID. So if you just request them, you're a school teacher or a college teacher, and they'll give you the free version. Even in the free version also, you would not be able to make word cloud, but you'll be able to play quiz the way I showed you. You can put unlimited questions out there. All right. So now let me show you how do you make one. Click on the symbol create on top. And you just create your first Kahoot right now. So it's very simple. It's quite easy and quite exhaustive in nature. Let me explain to you step by step. So you can just click on new Kahoot. Press new. And over here you start. First you give a title to your questions. So let's take, for example, I'll give title to my questions. So my title is, let's take digital marketing for teachers. I can give a description. How should teachers brand themselves? And if I want, I can keep the video to everyone. Everyone means everyone can see this openly also on Kahoot. They can search for your questions also. So just in case you're feeling lazy to make your own questions, you can just search questions on Kahoot as well. If some other teacher has made it public, you can also use that to play with your kids as well. So you need not make questions from scratch in that case. All right. And you can just click on done. Now, this is where you basically put the question. So first, let's take, if I put the question saying that, what is the first step? Let me just make more teacher-centric questions. I'll just say, which is the best app to engage with students? So my answer is, say, Kahoot, Zoom, Livestorm, or YouTube. Now, if I want to say the right answer, I'll just say this one. This is the right answer. If you want to put images, so let's take, if you're teaching a kid, they do not know how to read, you can also put images, by the way. So we can also add images as an answer, and we can put 4 images as well. So let's take, I want to say, so I'll just tell you, I'll give you an example of a kid in my second question. And then you see, you can put a time limit out here, 20 seconds, 30 seconds, 60 seconds, 90 seconds, whatever you want. So I'll just keep this at 30 seconds right now. And how much points you want to give them? So currently the points that are giving them is 1000. And they can do single select or multi-select. Suppose there are 2 answers, they can select multi-selections. If it's single, they can have single select. And just in case you want to put an image out here, you also put an image out here. For example, how many teachers do we have from nursery? Tap the word N on the chat box. If you're currently from nursery or you're teaching, say, kids at a smaller age group level. Okay, I can see a couple of nursery teachers out here. So in case you think that your kids can't read, you can actually, you know, have an image out here as well. You can also put images in the answer as well. Okay, then you just tick mark the right answer, whatever the right answer, just tick mark the right answer, and you go to add a new question. Then you create a new question. Let's say I want to give true and false. I can give true and false. So I'm going to say that something like this. So true and false, I can just put, today every teacher needs to go online. What do you think? It's true or false? I'll put the right answer as true. And then you can add a new question. Let's say I want to put any image. I can also put an image. I can also put a quiz again for people in nursery and pre-nursery. Click on this image button. And then you can just drag and drop image from here. So you can just take an image from Google or take any image from internet, and you can just drag and drop things. I can also use image library. And I can just search. So let's take, I just put an image of cow. So I just search for image, and I'll just search for images for cow. So this is image given by Kahoot for absolutely free, and for you can just say which animal is this, and then I can just say something like this. You can say cow. I can say calf. Well, calf is already there, so I'll just say tiger. I'll say bull. Or, you know, sparrow. Right answer is cow. So you can also make it more image friendly as well. Okay, for people. And that's again one of the best parts about Kahoot. So you can play with images, you can play with text, you can play with whatever you want. Now suppose if you want to add any open-ended questions. For example, you just want to say currently something like this. So you can use word cloud over here. And then you can just ask people to type something. So I can just say, you know, how do you feel today? And I can just leave it open. So in this, you don't have to type the right answers. People just have to type what they feel today. And you can say, what's the energy room? What's the energy in the room? Then you can say something like this. Again, word cloud. What is the first thing that comes to your mind when you hear the word maths, right? And you can just do that. So this will help you to build that rapport with people, because the more rapport you build, the better it is, right? And then you can also use polling. So let's take at the end of a session, you want to just conduct a poll. You want to say that how much did you enjoy today's session? And then you can just say good, excellent, bad, okay. Right now, in this, again, this is the right answer. People can select whatever they want, and that's how it is. And once you're done, you click on done on the chat box, and that's it. So then, when you click on done, you can just test it. So, suppose I want to test the code, I can just sort of test it over here whether the code is working absolutely fine or not. So then you can see, when you play the game, I'll show you how to play the game as well. So then you can just put the game pin, you say classic. So when you come to Kahoot, you can just press on the play button. When you do that, if you click on classic, it'll give you the game pin out here. The game pin is automatically generated. You don't have to do anything about it. Then as a student, they have to just basically type the game pin on their phone. If you go to kahoot.it, type the game pin. When you enter, they have to put their name. So always ask students to put the real names. If they don't put real name, you won't be able to see what their marks are. Let's take, I just put Hitesh. Press OK, go. When I do that, you know, so then Hitesh will come over here. Now, just in case, if you want to remove somebody, you can just remove. Let's take and remove Abba. I can just take and I can remove Abba currently. And once it's done, I can just click on start. And then I can keep on telling them questions. That's a digital marketing for teachers. In 3, 2, 1, the question comes over here. So let's take the poll. How much did you enjoy today's session? And you can see this will come to the student screen. So then they can type, you know, it's good, bad, okay, excellent. I can just say excellent. And, you know, so they will not see the options. They will only see the colors, okay, or the design. Once they click on that, if they just press okay, and once they press okay, the screen will come on the screen right now. As you can see, it's coming on my screen currently saying excellent. Is 58%, good was 31%, bad is 6%, okay, 6%. So I can get the percentage also in this case. All right. So are we clear with this, people? Did you guys love this section? No, it's not my app. It's an open app, Ambika. Okay, it's an open source. Anybody can use this. So this is what you should be doing, people. If you do this, your learnings will be more better. Are you getting confident? Are you feeling empowered right now? And are you feeling that you can make online learning also as interactive and as fun as the offline learning right now? Give me a big yes on the chat box, okay, where you can actually do this. So after you have done this, now how does your student grade? Very good question. Let me come back to my Kahoot. So once I've made my Kahoot and once I've done everything, okay, now how do I see what grade people have got? So let's also understand that as well. So let's take, I played this quiz with you, FDB quiz 2. Click on the small three arrows out here. Okay, and I can just go over here currently. Now when I go to this game, when I click inside, I can also edit my questions over here. And you can see 2.5 clears played currently, and I can see reports. So click on reports and you should be able to download reports in Excel sheet for your benefit. All right. And you can also find online report as well, which actually tells you which student got the answer right, which student got the answer wrong. And every single thing can be seen over here very, very easily. So you can see over here to finish the quiz. And I click on open. And I get to see the entire reports over here. So you can see, didn't finish with 2400. Need help with this thing. Difficult question was this: what is the first step to overcome hurdle in online teaching? Okay, so I get some overview analytics. Then you can see which were the players which played and how many got correct answers. So you can see everything comes through rank 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 10. You can see the top rankers. When I click on see more, I can see more ranks over here as well. And then we can see how many questions were unanswered, what's the final score for them. And we can see every single thing out here. All right. And suppose we see any questions coming from people. Okay, these were the questions which were given, and we can check which question was the easy, which question was the most difficult one for them. We get the entire report for each question as well. And we can basically then at the end, if you want, we can also have a feedback thing with them, and they can actually give feedback as well. So this is how you can actually play Kahoot in detail for people as well. Okay. Now, yes, you can also upload questions in Excel as well. No problem on that. So then you have to export an Excel sheet, or if you type for an Excel sheet and import it over there to get people in the MCQ format. So do you guys think that golden quadrant is what you need, to basically make it more effective? Now, what are the other ways to actually build more engagement? You can also have debates in the class. So for debates, again, my recommendation is use Kahoot for building debates, but one more app for using debate. Okay, we normally call this Edmodo. Let me explain this app to you as well. It's called Edmodo. Edmodo is actually an application for people in the K-12 or people in the nursery or people in the schools, but the same app can also be used for higher education as well. So first make an account. Again, this app is absolutely free. I'm not showing any paid apps. So whatever I'm showing is absolutely free. Ultimately, I'm a Sindhi, right? We all love free things, okay? So I'm going to show you everything which is free currently, okay? So we use Edmodo. So when you basically use Edmodo, you come to the Edmodo right now. And you first set up a classroom. So first you have to make an account. Again, making it very simple. Put your school name, put your address, put your name, etc. You put a class name. So let's say you put a class name as maths. I put my subject as something which is related to mathematics. And I put my select subject. I say basic maths. Select grade. So grade you can select is kindergarten, pre-kindergarten, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, eighth, ninth, 10th, 11th, 12th. Higher education, adult education. So we're going to say higher education for now. We're going to say next. Again, give a color to the subject. So you're giving a color to the subject, which is blue, right? And when you come to Edmodo, Edmodo is like your Facebook for school. So every person can actually make, every school or every college can actually make an online classroom. When you make an online classroom like this, you can add students. Then second step is to add students. So what is the first step, people? Set up a classroom. Okay, write down on chat box. Write down on your notepad. First step, go to Edmodo, E-D-M-O-D-O. Second step, make a class. Make a subject. So let's take, you should have a digital lead in your college who will help to make all subjects for you, right? Then we can add teachers and we can add students. So then we basically add students over here, where now I'll just give email IDs to people. I can just say, for example, Roshni, Tarani, and I give ID as TaraniRoshni@gmail.com. And then I just say Neil.Dodia89@gmail.com. So I'll just basically put email IDs and the name of people. I click on add students. So when I do that, what happens is students basically get added, okay, in my session. Now, once the students are currently added in the session, what typically happens is they will be actually be able to participate with you. And suppose if I want to connect a parent, now let's take if my kids are very small, then I can also say connect parent, and I can actually also connect, I can also put their parents' email IDs so their parents can log in and keep. Which is this application is made in a very systematic fashion, all right, to onboard students and onboard parents as well. Now, we are going to onboard parents over here, I'll say maybe later. And once I do that, Then what I can simply do is I can click on post, like just like Facebook, and I can put my post out here. Suppose if I want to keep it open, so let's think I'm in an open classroom right now. I want all of you to currently come to this classroom. I can just tell all of you currently to go to edmodo.com, make an account and use this code to come to my class. So it's EQ9TR9. Okay, and then all of you will openly be able to come to my class. And then once I do that, I can actually start putting down my questions out here. So I can just start a discussion. So I'll just say, which, you know, when it comes to maths, what subjects, what topics are you currently struggling with? So then what happens is people actually start, students will start posting over here, they start posting answers over here. And the moment most students post answers, the system will keep on calculating their engagement level. It'll tell you which one is more engaged and they'll keep on giving them badges. So it's like gamification of students as well. And suppose if I got an assignment as a college, as a school, as a teacher, I can also put my assignment over here. I can also play something like this. I can just say, you know, let's have a debate on Pythagoras theorem, right? And how do you think it's helpful? So then I can actually open debates over here. And then people keep on responding to questions out here. I keep on answering the questions over here live. And we actually help them, you know, to facilitate online learning. So you can also have open debates with people. You can also use chat box as well. But when the students is too large, you want to keep a record of the chats, which is why you have to use this tool called Edmodo, right? It's a social media for students. It's absolutely free. Any school can get onboarded over here and you all can use it. Suppose if you want to give some assignments, you want to give some tasks, this is also a good tool for giving a task and assignment as well. Click on the plus sign, click on create assignment, and you'll be able to give them assignments as well. You can give a deadline to the assignment as well. So when a student gets logged in, so I'll just say, for example, maths problems, and I give them instructions. Think, for example, finish it in 2 hours. If I want, I can give attachment, I can add it to a library, I can do all that things over here. And now I click on assign on top. Then I need to select a due date. So let's say my due date for this session is 15th or 22nd, 11:59 p.m. After this time, the assignment will get locked. Nobody can take up assignment after that. Then I'm going to say add to the gradebook. So the moment people start responding to the question, their grades will also get calculated automatically. So you can start putting your questions, you can start putting your problems over here. And I guess you finish in 2 hours, 0 submissions so far. And then I can also add a lot of submissions out here. So this is basically more open-ended, where I can just put a question in the description box. People start answering the questions. And then we see the submissions and we give them marks over there. So again, it's very interactive, very cool. You can use this tool as well for yourself. It's called Edmodo. Great. So as we can see, Princey is saying that I was a student when I used to log into Edmodo. Yes, it's very similar to Google Classroom, Doctor. Right? So you need to just make a new account for that in that case. So did you guys love this so far? Are you guys enjoying this till now? Give me a quick yes on the chat box in case you love it and you're finding your time worth spending over here with us today. Okay. Now, a third interaction mode for you can also be video, right? Where you can actually ask people to, you can share recorded videos with them. So again, you can aid, you know, your schools with video combined with your offline classrooms, with your online live classrooms. So what you can simply do is, for video, you can look at my past video called Talent LMS. I have given an entire lowdown on how to make a learning management system for yourself for absolutely free. And you can actually use LMS. You can actually use learning management system. Okay, so just watch my first video. So go to my YouTube channel. There's a chapter called How to Take Your College Online. And you can actually use that for yourself to actually build a talent LMS. And you can also use YouTube videos to give video assignments to people. So your in-article assignments will be this, having quiz, having debate, having video. And last thing is what we call is simulations. What are simulations? Simulation is very simple. So basically you just find an online timer app. So I'll just find an online timer app currently. And I will tell people that currently I'm giving you approximately 5 minutes. Okay. And you can give them a scenario. For example, the scenario that I can give you over here is I can say, let's take for example that you need to come up with a marketing strategy for a travel company right now. how can a travel company do branding at this point of time for pandemic? Put in your answers in the next 5 minutes on chat box. So people are putting their answers. Or one other trick what you can use, you can actually use what we call as Google Sheets. You can just go to drivergoogle.com, since you all have Google Gmail account with yourself. You can use Google Sheets. I can just click on new, and I can just click on new sheets over here currently. New Google Docs. And then I can put my scenario over here. So I can just simply put my scenario. So let's take, for example, I just type over here something like this. Travel plan. For travel plan, marketing plan for travel company. This is a very challenging question, by the way, right? Using social media. And then I click on button called share. When I click on share, I can also make this document public in nature. So what I can do is I can just click on, say for example, change the link with anyone. And anyone with this link can actually come to the sheet. I can just copy this link over here. And suppose I want to keep it shorter, I can use this tool called bit.ly, bit.ly, which is a URL shortener tool. From where I can shorten the URLs, I can keep it very short. Why? Because the current URL is very big. You see such a big URL. I come to bit.ly, I click on create, and I put this link over here. And then I can customize this link. So I can just type over here something like FDP Live SS. And I can just copy this link and I can just put it on a PowerPoint slide. And I can tell people that you've got 5 minutes. We're starting the quiz at 12:07. And we're going to end the quiz. We're going to end the session by 12:13. And then I can also put this link. Okay, if people on YouTube, you can just type the link directly. And I can also basically, put this link over here on the chat screen as well. Now, when I do that, when I put this link on the chat screen, okay, what happens? People will start coming to this link. They'll start answering the questions out there. So I just put the link on the chat for everybody. And if suppose you're seeing my screen right now, you can just simply use this screen. You can actually simply use this link to go to the link right now and you can answer the question. Okay, so it's very simple. So what you do is for simulation game, give them a scenario. So tell them that, okay, what if this particular person is doing something? What if that particular person is doing something? So give them a scenario. Then you go to Google Docs and you open up a blank sheet and you give the sheet access to people. So anybody clicking on this link right now will go to Google Docs. They can type their answers. They can type the questions out here. Or you can tell them to chat. If your number of people are small, then you can use the chat box as well. My number of people are very big. It's 4,000 people right now. So practically it's impossible for me to look at the chat buttons, but I can actually use Google Sheets for easing my process out. Okay. And then I can give a timer. And if I want, I can also basically open a timer on Google as well. So I can just go to online timer. Open this timer screen. I guess 59 seconds left. I can also basically give the link out here as well. So I can just simply make this a bit smaller and I can simply put the stopwatch and the link together. Right. And I can essentially, I can just increase the font size of this. I can make it pretty big. And you can just, so this is a simulation game. So simulation is very simple. You just need to simulate, you just need to give them a scenario and ask people to type things. So just some hacks which you can actually use for yourself, which you can actually use to engage with your participants, engage with your students, so that they start loving your sessions, they start interacting with you, and you can start giving them absolute live classes the way I'm doing with you right now, right? Pretty simple. Let me just move this one a bit smaller. And once the timer is over, it will basically say, okay, and timer is up. Then you can just stop the sheet. So what you can simply do is, once people have written responses on the sheet, you go to the Google Sheet again. I'll go to the Google Sheet right now and I'll just stop it. So you can see there are about 80 some people currently on the sheet right now. Then even they can type whatever I'm seeing, even they can see it. Whatever I am writing, even they can write. Whatever, you know, they are currently writing, even they can see over here. So anybody with this sheet can actually type with us on the spot. So I've only kept it view, my bad. I can keep it edit. So when I click on edit, now everybody else can type simultaneously with me. So I missed one step, my bad for all of you. So you can just click on edit and then everybody can come to the sheet and they can start typing their answers over here. I only kept it view only. So in view only, what happens? Only when I type, they see it. But when I keep it edit, I can actually edit the same link and then people can start writing over here as well. So this is how you can actually facilitate online learning, my friends. By using quizzes, by using debates, by using simulation. I think there are a lot more people in the sheet right now, which is why, you know, even the server is, even Google is gone down because of power of all the teachers, right? But you can try this in your free time. It's very easy, it's not that difficult. And you should be able to do this as well. Otherwise, because normally your numbers will be very small, you know, over here, we're getting a lot of people over here. But then yes, you can also ask them to type in the chat box, or you can just tell them to go to Google Docs, type their answers and share the sheet with you. So when they kind of share the sheet with all of you, then, you know, you can actually assess the sheets for them, right? So this is what you need to do, my friends. These are some ways, some hacks of online learning. So I'll just again put this golden quadrant for all of you. So then you can also use videos. You can do some gap analysis. You can basically make a report card on Excel sheet. And you can just see what's the progress first, what's the progress later for every student. So you can intimate the parents how the students is faring. You can play games the way we did play gameplay right now. These are all the in-class activities you need to plan. And when you plan your curriculum and design like this, trust me, you will be the top 1% of online teachers who are utilizing the best of ability to teach online. So how many people over here, okay, you actually think that this was eye-opener for you? You never thought that learning can be done in such a different fashion as well. If you think it was an eye-opener for you, type the word EO on the chat box. Type the word EO on the chat box. Anything is also eye-opener for you. Because, you know, you never thought that learning can be also made so much fun. In the online space as well. Type the word EO on the chat box, right? So these are some tips which I've shared with you. I've got a lot more, but the time, unfortunately, is very less with me, right? But yes, you can actually do that for yourself. So after you've done this, okay, after you've made a golden quadrant, the second step you should be doing, you should make a week-wise plan. You can say, okay, you can either make a day-wise or a week-wise plan. You can say week number 1, 2, 3 or day number 1, 2, 3. So let's say, for example, like if I have to make a week-wise plan for my own curriculum, I'll say day number 1, I'll teach you fundamentals of digital marketing. Day number 2, I'll teach you how to make creatives. Day number 3, I'll teach you how to write effective content for yourself. Now, when I do that, when I make a day-wise and week-wise plan, then I can share this with the students. I'm also very clear what I have to teach each day. I plan my assignments accordingly, plan my activity accordingly, and I'll start sharing things with people. And when you do this, good things will happen to you. You will be, first of all, able to adapt to new technologies. Number 2, you will be able to plan and design your own online environment and your own online curriculum for yourself. And number 3, you will be able to make effective presentations for yourself. All right. And now how to start preparing for modules. This is a checklist of mine, which you can actually use. You can just take a snapshot of this. Number 1, okay, make an online schedule for yourself. So make a schedule that when I'm going to teach a lesson, what I'm going to teach a lesson on. Then number 2, make a golden quadrant. The first plan, then make a golden quadrant. 4 things. Syllabus. What's the second option for you? Key learning. Then interactive classrooms. In-class activity. And then timeline. Skit. Remember the skit. The 3rd thing is plan your class activity. Plan what you're going to do with the students. Next, motivate your kids to participate. Because the more they participate, the more even you will get motivated. Okay. And the last thing, combined with recorded video. So just in case you feel that, you know, live is becoming a tough, combined with recorded videos, use YouTube, Udemy, Coursera, because there were a lot of free lessons out there for all of you. And last thing is finalize things and share with people. This is how you start preparing for your online modules. And when you do this, my friends, good things will happen to all of you. And ultimately, learning can become more fun for everyone out here. How many of you people currently loved being a part of this over here? Right? And you think that this was a complete eye-opener for you currently. You never imagined that designing a curriculum can be so much fun, right? So this is a power, my friends. This is exactly what you can actually do for yourself. So now the time comes for the test, okay? This is a test link for all of you. You need to go to this link right now, bit.ly/testfdp1. Go to this link, bit.ly/testfdp1. And when you go for this test out here, okay, you can actually give your test. This is how you mark your attendance. So only people who give the test will be getting the certificates. People who do not give the test will be getting the certificates. So it is Coursera, Cletus, Coursera, Coursera. And second one is what we call is Udemy, Udemy. So go to this link, give your tests. I'm waiting for a minute over here. Till time, all of you complete this. Keep the link out there. I've already shared the link with all of you. Just check, it's already there in the chat box for all of you. Hold on to the chats. Don't chat anything. If you keep on chatting, I won't be able to post the link. Just do not chat. Do not put anything in the chat box on Zoom right now. Because my screen is just buzzing. Sometimes my computer freezes out here because of so much of volume. Just wait. My team on YouTube, if you're there on YouTube, my team, just put the link out there on YouTube as well for people. You also have the testing in the description box on YouTube so that, you know, it will be easier for all of you to follow it up.
Hi, Hitesh. Can you make one request to everyone? Ask them to subscribe and enable their notification on YouTube. Correct. Because not everyone is able to join the WhatsApp group because they are full and we are not able to make more than what we have.
Correct. Okay, so people, we cannot make more WhatsApp groups. So my only request is to please, first of all, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Subscribe to it. Okay, because if you don't subscribe to it, you won't get notification. But tomorrow when you come live at 11 o'clock again, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. All right, because the moment we come live, you'll get a notification in your YouTube, and then we are live, and you can come attend a session live tomorrow. We cannot make more WhatsApp group because the WhatsApp groups are full, and it becomes very tedious task for us to manage our WhatsApp group. Okay, so please subscribe to our YouTube channel and come over there tomorrow at the same time. Also, we've got some more announcements to make. So in case after you give the test, just hold on for 1 or 2 minutes, and I'll be able to make this announcement for you. I'll hold on for a moment for all of you, and then I'll go forward. Just give me one moment, please.
Hi all, if the link is not opening, it's purely because of the number of traffic. Please try after some time, it will work. Just try after some time because so many people are going on the link, that's why it's crashing. So please try after some time and it will definitely work. Thank you for your cooperation.
Okay, so the test link is also there on your YouTube description link right now. So go to YouTube description link and you can just check the test link out there as well. All right. So now I've got some more announcements to make for all of you over here currently. All right. So now we also have an upcoming bootcamp for teachers. We're having a digital marketing teachers bootcamp. It's a 3-day bootcamp starting 15th, 16th and 17th. We're going to teach you how to market yourself and how to to personal branding. So in this case, it's going to be a pure digital marketing session for teachers and only for teaching community. We already got over 340 teachers registering for it. We're going to close the registrations very, very soon. And it's only at a throwaway price of 500 rupees right now, 499 rupees at this point in time. So on day number one and 15th, we're going to teach you fundamental digital marketing. Day number two, we're going to teach you how to do content marketing and blogging for teachers. And day number three, we'll teach you how to use LinkedIn to brand yourself. Because these three, again, are very, very important mediums for all the teachers today to go digital, go online and brand themselves. So we're going to teach you that as well. In case if you're keen, you can do your enrollment today, right? And then we will start making WhatsApp group of teachers and we will start having, this is only paid FDP currently. This is not a free one. So in case if you're keen, okay, then you'll be able to do this, all right? And remember people to take the test before today because that's how we'll be assessing people basis, you know, people who give the test. So it's going to be very easy, multiple choice question. It's not that difficult. And I'm also putting the link for the training bootcamp, okay, currently on your chat window. And you're also going to put the same thing on YouTube as well. How many guys over here, by the way, have enrolled for the, who already enrolled for this teacher bootcamp? Give me a quick eye on the chat box in case you've enrolled already for teacher's bootcamp currently. So you can just go to your Chrome browser, type on chat box bit.ly/FDB bootcamp. Or you can also go to Nordstrom Academy site. And over there also, we have put the FDB bootcamp link. So this is a bootcamp only for teachers starting 15th May to 17th of May. So this is, if you want to brand yourself, you want to start doing something, you know, you want to start reaching out to people, start doing something on your own, then this particular bootcamp is currently for you. All right. So why is this bootcamp so important? It's very important today because ultimately if you see Byju's, why is Byju's Byju's today? It's because of good personal branding. Why is this Chauhan sir with a personal branding? Correct. So in case you want to be a brand, it's very, very important that apart from teaching, you also have marketing skills. You also learn how to be an effective marketer you start sharing valuable lessons, because the amount of knowledge a teacher has, that knowledge unfortunately is not shared among people. So remember, people, as I told you in my starting statement, the best teacher in the market does not win. The best known teacher in the market always wins. You need to become the best known. And the more best known you are, the better it is. Why? Because then you get more opportunities, then more colleges want to collaborate with you, more schools want to collaborate with you, more people want to collaborate with you. You know, you work with them, you become like an influencer in the teaching community. That's what we're going to teach you in this particular bootcamp. Also, at Nordstrom Academy, we do a lot of teacher trainings. We also do live and recorded trainings for your students. So we've got a lot of courses for your students as well. Plus, we also do co-branded courses. So let's take, for example, a particular college or particular institute wants to do a co-branding with us for their students. We can also have a joint certification launch for your students as well, and even for the FDPs as well. So suppose if some university professors out here or some chancellors are out here, we're more than happy to also conduct an FDP for your entire university. But all these things will be priced, all right? And they're very economical. We're not very expensive. Right, because currently we want to give out to people. That's what our aim is. Because a lot of institutions, chancellors, vice chancellor reached out to us in the last week, and they've told us they want to know. It's very difficult for us to reply to everybody, which is why we're using this opportunity to tell you all about our services right now. A lot of teachers are requested for the link for the bootcamp, which we're not able to give because we're tied up making this event for you guys currently, which is why. So now this is the test link on the left-hand side, the bootcamp link on the right-hand side, and the question answer link at the end. If you want, I'm happy to take some question answers. Do not ask your question answers over the chat. I would not be able to see the question answers in that case. You know, I want you guys to actually go to this link over here, bit.ly/NSAcademyQuestion, and you can ask your questions to me over there. So just go to a Chrome browser, type out there, it'll open a Google form up for you. And with that Google form, I'll be able to answer your questions. So I hope that you enjoyed today. I hope that you loved things today. All right. And I hope that you had your time worthwhile. So let me just do a very quick thing before we click question answers. I want all the teachers currently to click a photograph of this. This is a certify that I was a part of FDP on 13th May on online course design and planning. If you want, click a picture of this, tag your name, and you can put it up on Instagram. You can put it up on Facebook. You can put it up on your WhatsApp. I'll just shut my video off for a moment. You can take a good picture of this. And you should be also be able to tag @NordstromAcademy on Instagram, YouTube, and you can tag me, Hitesh Motwani, on Instagram as well, right? So I'll be more than happy to be tagged. I'll be more than happy to, see that all of you guys are currently learning so much with us. So I hope you click the photograph. Okay, cool. Now we'll take some question answers. So you can just click on this, you can just not click, but you can just put your questions, go to the Chrome browser, type on the chat box, bit.ly/NSAcademyQuestion. And in case you want to give a test, bit.ly/testFDP1. And in case you want to register with bootcamp, bit.ly/FDP bootcamp. These are the most important link for all of you. You can click on these links and you can actually ask us questions and ask us whatever you want. All right. Now, let me open my drive up so I can answer your question. But first of all, did you guys love it today? Do you think this was one of the best sessions you ever heard online? Because we're currently striving to give you value. That's what we ultimately aim for. Our only aim is to give value and empower teachers. Because, I think if the only thing that can change the world are teachers. Without teachers, nobody can do whatever they want to do in life. Education is a stepping stone to any bright future. Correct. So before we conclude, I want to understand that how many guys over here thought that this was one of the best FDPs you ever heard, and you were able to go out there and make a difference. It's actually made a difference to your life. Because if you see this, when we plan a program, we only plan a program in one way, how it can help anybody to make a difference in people's life. And that's what my aim is. My aim is to basically make a difference in everybody's life. At Nordstrom Academy, we really believe in this, that, we want to actually change your life. And I'm so grateful to all of you once again for making this successful, for making us, giving us an opportunity to serve all of you. So thank you so much. All right. So certificates will come after some time. Okay, so one more request, please do not call, message us for certificates. Have patience. We've got over 8,000 registrants. People whose name is appearing in both the lists, today's list and tomorrow's list. Technically, whoever is giving the test tomorrow only he or she will get a certificate if the name appears in both the lists today and tomorrow. All right. And then what we're going to do is, you know, you're going to get a certificate via an email or a WhatsApp group. So don't exit the WhatsApp groups, because WhatsApp groups are the only place where we can keep on communicating back to you and keep on informing you about the newer FDPs and the newer initiative we're launching for you. So do not exit the WhatsApp group. Okay. I have a sincere request to all of you. Anna, I'll try to do that. I try, but you know, as you know, that there are about more than required people. So which is why it becomes a bit difficult for us, but definitely I'll try to be a bit slow. Right, but you can always refer back to the recording. All the recordings will be there on YouTube channel. In case people are on YouTube, please go to YouTube, click on subscribe, okay? And you'll get notifications from all of us. And you'll also get the session over there as well. So don't worry, Meghna, you will be very amazing. In fact, all the teachers will be as amazing, you know, after the session. So it's all about practicing. You have to practice. Practice makes the man perfect. You know, I have been practicing this as well for a very long time. So please, okay, practice. Okay, let's see what question answers we've got. So, okay, by the way, we've got one more thing. We've got a group. Just give me 1 second, people. 1 second, huh? Okay. Also one more thing that we have for all of you today. Okay. Before I take the question answers, 1 second, wait. Is we are announcing also one more initiative for all the people. Is now, last time we had one of the students event, and it was only successful because of all of you, purely because you guys shared it with all your communities. So I believe that teachers have a lot of power in bringing about a change, bringing about a word of mouth. So we're launching one more series for us right now. We normally call this the Digital Marketing Executive Program. This time, the next program for digital marketing that we have for students, for teachers, is not only available for, you know, just for students, it's available for everybody, right? So the link of registration for that will be available with you on your chat windows, okay, and sometime from now. And the link for how to register will also be available to you on YouTube as well in the description box. So look at the description box and you should be able to look at things over there. And I'm also going to basically, you know, share with you the link over here right now to all of you. And then if you want, you can invite whomever you want. You can invite your students, you can invite your colleagues, you can invite business people, family members. Everybody is invited for this session, because this is that one of the sessions which can actually help you to change somebody's life. Okay, because ultimately you're gonna make a bigger difference in people's lives. So again, you've got this absolutely free series called Digital Marketing Executive Program. It's for everyone and anyone who wants to be in digital space. Let me just put up the creators for all of you. One second. I'll keep your questions coming on the NS Academy questions. I'll be answering them one by one live for all of you. Just give me a moment. Let me just put that link up. So the link over here is 1 second, wait.
Hitesh, I'll put the link on the chat.
Okay, cool. So Neil has put the link on the chat for all of you. And this is the creative. And this is called Digital Marketing, Free Digital Marketing Executive Workshop for people from 23rd to 24th of May for everybody, for students. Now, this is not specific for teachers. This is open for everybody. So you can, if you want, you can go ahead and share this with, you know, whomever you want to share it. And this is going to help you to actually plan your digital marketing journey step by step for anybody who wants to do that. All right. So test link, Dina, is already there in the description box. We already given test link to you. You can just have a look at that. So FDB test one is a test link. So we just put the link in the description box over there. You can have a look at that one. Just give me a moment. Okay. So here are all the links for you in one place. So you can actually go over here to each and any of these and you can actually use it for yourself. Let me now look at some question answers from all of you. And in case, if you're done, you can leave the webinar if you want. Now I'm just taking some question answers from people. The webinar is currently over. So thank you so much for coming in. But if you want some questions, then you can stay back and I'll be basically more than happy to give any questions to all of you. Let me do the question answers over here. Okay, so we've got some questions. We have a lot of questions, in fact. Let's take some questions. Okay, Shruti asking, for Kahoot, do we need a laptop or a desktop and a mobile? Yes, for Kahoot, a laptop is compulsory. You cannot just run the quiz on a mobile phone, unfortunately. If you want to display it on your screen, if you want to do a self-paced thing, then mobile phone should be okay, Shruti. Okay? Kahoot is free. Okay, if you must have used Business and Girish, which is why showing paid. So remember, when you make an account, do not use Business. You have to put that you're from a school. Only if you put from a school, then you can do this. So Tarak, unfortunately, we're not accepting any NFTs, but you can just click on the link. There's option for NFT over there itself, and you can do NFT over there. Okay. Then we'll try to do the next bootcamp in the evening, Kirti. All right, explain about Edmodo. So I already explained about it, Edmodo, Raghuram. Watch my video, which are there. But Edmodo is a social media tool, essentially, which will help you to plan your social media marketing better. Okay, so Edmodo is a social media tool. Just give me a moment, please. Okay. So somebody asking that, okay, this bootcamp will get certificates? Yes, in bootcamp, you will be getting certificates. So certificates will be coming to you on your WhatsApp group or email. We haven't decided yet because it depends on the number of volume, Sachi. Depending on the volume, you'll be able to do that. So, no, the child used to only have one device. The one has a desktop in front of him where you can see the questions. That's what you need. Okay. So again, register for the bootcamp, guys. Register it soon because we're not going to have beyond a certain limit of people. So which is why bootcamp is for a very limited time at our end. So please remember that we're not going to have a bootcamp for a very prolonged time. Okay, so just remember to do that. And yes, you get a certificate for bootcamp as well. Let me see if I have more questions. Can we do all these apps in Kahoot, Edmodo, into Classroom? No, Google Classroom, and they are different. So Google Classroom has their own apps in their own thing. So you cannot use in that. So gap analysis is basically where you actually figure out the gap of your student. Okay, where you can check what are the student progress, you know, week on week or month on month. So when you're speaking to a student, you know that where is he falling short and where is he going good. So where is falling short, you just try to work on those skill sets for students. That's called gap analysis. So Kushal is asking, can you please suggest us more tools for assignments? Yes, Kushal, you should look at my FDB3 video of last time. So go to YouTube channel, search for FDB3 Nordstrom Academy, or search for how to assess online courses, okay, by Hitesh Motwani or Nordstrom Academy. You'll be able to find that video on YouTube. And I've given a lot of tools over there how to do assessments apart from the ones I showed you today. Yes, you can also use for academic purpose. Edmodo can be used for academic purposes as well. Simulation is, Deepa, Seema Singh, what is simulation? Simulation technically is what we currently did. Like I give you a scenario. Let's take, if you have to do a digital marketing strategy for a travel plan, how would you do that? It's a simulation. I'm giving you a case study, right? And you have to come up with a plan, a proper strategy in action, live on the spot with us. If you just put up a link, you can also share with the link. So Shampa is asking, can I share a simulation page, Kahoot, Edmodo all at once? Yes. You can just share links of things, these things with people, and then they can start participating with you. But if you go one by one. So somebody's asking for the test. So there'll be one test today, one test tomorrow. So today you get the first test. The test two will happen tomorrow, Vanita. So then somebody is asking me, considering the current scenario, I'm using YouTube videos in unlisted format. Yes, you can use YouTube in unlisted format. That's absolutely fine. Okay. See, bootcamp link is in the description. So people typing on YouTube, bootcamp link is also in the description. Click on the description link and you can actually register for the bootcamp. Okay. What about Google Classroom? So currently, Pushpar Gaya, we're not covering Google Classroom. I think everybody, Google is already covering a lot of free lessons out there. Just go to YouTube and check it out. We might upload a YouTube lesson on Google Classroom. And if I get time tomorrow, I'll probably show that to you. But remember, guys, tomorrow, if you come at 11 o'clock, all right, tomorrow we're going to have a lot of fun. I'm going to show you what are the best practices for online teachers. Right? And in case if you like it, share this link with your friends. Tell them to come to our bootcamp tomorrow. Tell them to come to our session workshop tomorrow because it's really going to help you change somebody else's life. So please, please, please help us spread the word. And also, you know, we got a Facebook group. So I want all of you guys to go to our Facebook group. So just go to facebook.com and type Digital Ready Professors by Nordstrom Academy. Even we'll put that link in the description of the video. Okay, type Digital Ready Professors. And you'll find this group by Nordstrom Academy. Join this group because all the information that you're going to get is going to come in this group for all of you. Okay. It's one of the hubs for all the teachers. You can also connect with like-minded people out here. Right. So join this group. You've got about 2,800 members out here. Join it to embrace things in real time. So simulation, now somebody's asking me, how can simulation help for students? It can definitely help students purely because of one reason, okay? That you are stimulating their brain for real life scenarios. Because if you're not really doing that, you know, the student ultimately will have theoretical knowledge, you want a practical knowledge. So please use case studies and simulation. That is one way you can actually change somebody's life. So no, there are no videos on simulation, unfortunately, Sushmita. What is the key factor that one should be identified for students for a better understanding of the concept? So the same which I told you, keep them interactive, Deban Ranjan. Keep them interactive. The more interactive you keep them, the more they will enjoy. So NS Nordi is asking, is NS Academy continuing to conduct this entire year? Hopefully, yes, we should be able to. Don't exit the WhatsApp groups. And for any update, join our Facebook groups. When you join our Facebook groups, you should be able to actually, you know, attend all our sessions. You'll be able to get updated on sessions live because sometimes WhatsApp becomes a very tedious task for all of us. So Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube are three medias that keep on announcing new things. So please subscribe us on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube for this. Can we have videos in Kahoot and ask questions like a poll? I'm not sure, Savio. I'm not really sure about that, but I don't think you can add videos. You can only add images from what I know. Do we get the recording? Yes, you'll get the recording of the session on YouTube. Everything that I'm teaching you right now will be available on our YouTube channel for all of you. And if you want, you can also follow me on Instagram, Hitesh Motwani, follow Neil Dodia, our other co-founder on Instagram, and follow Tarani Roshni, our third co-founder on Instagram. Because we also keep on announcing everything on our personal handles and our company handles as well. So you can actually do that as well. Okay. Now, any more? Let me see some more questions trickling in. Just last few minutes and then we shut the webinar off. Okay. So can we add, do we get for tomorrow's session, we will get the new link in WhatsApp? Yes, you get the new link on WhatsApp and email Arva. Don't worry about it. Or you can just subscribe to our YouTube channel. You will get a notification automatically for tomorrow's session. How does diversity play out in classroom? It totally depends on your Dr. Mahesh. How do you plan your diversity in the classroom? You can use these quizzes to plan diversity as well. So guys, I hope you had a lot of fun. Let me also announce the name of people who came in today. Okay. Just give me one moment, please. So let's make an announcement of all the people whose payment we've received so far on InstaMojo, our payment gateway. And thank you so much for registering. And we're going to have this on 15th, 16th, 17th of May, 11 to 12:30, same time. And if you miss a class, you'll also get the recording of the bootcamp as well. Okay. Let us see. So we've got payment of Sunil D'Souza, Sadaf, Neha, Aarti, Sarika, Sai Shri Lakshmi, Nahida, Shweta, Syamla, Dr. Rasika, Shweta, Shweta Lath, okay, Samarth Vyas, Sanobar, Mayuri, Dr. Meghna, Ishant, Bidisa, Reshma Dedia, Ketan, then Richa, Dhanashri, Padmavati, Jyoti, Ashwin, Hiral, Dr. Vijaya, Dr. Pradeep, Anupama, Aarti Devi, Dr. Nasreen, Vidya Lakshmi, Shruti, Mubin, Rahul, Margaret, Monali, Gracie, and Shilpa. Let me just see who all are there. Then Geeta, Dr. Nagnath, Dilip Kumar, and Aditi Prakash Sharma. I want to confirm that we got your payments. All right, we got your payments. So this link, which is there, you can do NEFT from that. You can actually do Google Pay on that. You can do Paytm. You can do everything on one link itself. All right. So that's it. Then we end the webinar over here. We got some more right now trickling in. Let me read the latest names. We got Sir Desar Deshmukh, Sunil D'Souza, and Sadaf Rizvi as well. So once again, guys, thank you so much for joining in. I'll see you guys tomorrow, same time at 11 o'clock. And please spread the word with your friends, spread the word with everybody else. In case you want to share the link of this particular session for them to register, you can actually use this. The team will also put up this link in the description video over here. Okay, FTP V2. So this is the link. bit.ly/FDP version 2. All right, this link is also there in our Facebook groups as well. It'll be there put up on our Instagram as well. It'll be put up everywhere. Okay, no, that's not the wrong link. Let me just get the right link for all of you. Give me one moment, please. Yeah. So FDP V2. Okay, that's the link. So as you can see over here, when you open up, this will be the page which will open up for all of you. Okay, this is a workshop only for teachers. And this is the link. If you want, you can share it with your fellow teachers, fellow classmates, fellow colleagues, so that they can take the full benefit of tomorrow's session as well. So once again, thank you so much. It's a pleasure to all of you, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye-bye.